based on the radiograph diagnosis is. So in this radiographic image, we see this lucent or lytic lesion here, a well-defined lesion, and it is in the epiphysis. So this is the epiphysis, this is the physial plate between the metaphysis and the epiphysis. So this well-defined lytic lesion in the epiphysis in an unfused skeleton, so epiphyseal lesion in unfused skeleton where the physial plate has not closed, it is chondroblastoma. So epiphyseal lesion in unfused skeleton is chondroblastoma, which is also called as Codman tumor. Codman tumor was initially the term used for chondroblastoma of proximal humerus. So that is how the term has come, Codman tumor, by the person who saw the signs first. So Codman tumor is chondroblastoma. Now, if we see a epiphyseal lesion in a fused skeleton like this, so this again here, epiphyseal region, there is this lytic lesion well defined, but the physial plate here is closed. The epiphysis and the metaphysis are fused. So epiphyseal lesion in a fused skeleton, it is giant cell tumor. So the difference is chondroblastoma is epiphyseal lesion in unfused skeleton. Giant cell tumor is epiphyseal lesion in fused skeleton. Coming to Brody's abscess. Brody's abscess is generally seen in the metaphysis because basically it is osteomyelitis. So osteomyelitis is more common in metaphysis. So it is seen in the metaphysis. It is an oval lesion like this, vertically oriented along the axis of the bone. And as we see here, it has this sclerotic rim. So well-defined lytic lesion with sclerotic rim in the metaphysis. Most common cause here, according to the options, is Brody's abscess, which is basically osteomyelitis. Chondrosarcoma versus chondroblastoma. Chondrosarcoma will be seen in older age. It's a malignant lesion. It will be seen in older age. While chondroblastoma, as we said, would be younger age, less than 20 years, generally males, and unfused skeleton. So this is about the lesions in the bone.